Is beauty truly in the eye of the beholder? Apparently not so much. As it turns out, there's some math involved. Here's what researchers have discovered about just what it is that makes a person's face attractive, scientifically speaking, of course. According to psychologist Anthony Little, humans have an appreciation for symmetrical-seeming faces. As the psychologist revealed to the website Science News for Students, symmetry looks normal to us, and we then like it. However, the psychologist further explained that people only think they prefer symmetrical faces, explaining that what we're really attracted to are mathematically average faces, which are less about symmetry and more about the specific features on a person's face, as well as their arrangement. While symmetry has long been thought to be a key factor in attractiveness, a 2004 study showed that plenty of folks find mathematically average faces attractive, whether they're perfectly symmetrical or not. During the study, researchers discovered that manipulating a picture of a person's face shape to become more of an average shape, while not manipulating the faces to appear more symmetrical, spurred participants to rate the faces as more attractive. This was true whether the volunteer viewed a profile shot or a head-on photo. Likewise, when the same images were, quote, morphed away from the average shape, viewers found them to be less attractive. Chris Solomon, a world-renowned expert in facial mapping technology, elevated the beautiful face experiment to a whole new level. Using a computer program generally reserved for crafting facial composites of criminals, Solomon commissioned people to create what they considered to be the perfect face. 100 volunteers were then tasked with rating each face for attractiveness. In the end, the expert discovered 2 faces, one male and one female, that are considered the epitome of beauty. However, it's important to note that this study was conducted in the UK, and as Solomon noted, a study in Africa or Asia would definitely have different results. After settling on the most aesthetically pleasing female face, the study also evaluated celebrity faces to find the one most comparable. Solomon and his team named Natalie Portman as the best match for the female composite. No word on if Portman knows she has one of the most scientifically pleasing faces, but who wouldn't be flattered by that?
Oh, that's nice.
Yes.
Thank you.
What makes Natalie Portman's face or the original composite from Chris Solomon's study so alluring? Well, it all comes down to a combination of features and spacing. In an interview with The Telegraph, Solomon broke down all the different components of the most beautiful female face, starting with the shape. According to Solomon and his team, the most aesthetically pleasing face is heart-shaped. Heart-shaped faces, like actress Reese Witherspoon's, are often categorized by high cheekbones, width at the top of the face, and a narrow chin. The aesthetic composite also has near-perfect facial symmetry, which further proves the importance of symmetry, at least when it comes to attractiveness. According to Chris Solomon's study, the so-called most attractive female face has eyebrows that are both shaped and arched. There's no denying that the furry caterpillars above your eyes are pretty magical beasts. With a few tweaks and tweezes, eyebrows have some major transformative power, perhaps more so than any other facial feature.
Relax. That's relaxed?
Jared Bailey, a global brow expert for Benefit Cosmetics, revealed to InStyle, "Eyebrows can really contour and change the shape and appearance of your overall look by bringing balance and proportion to not only your eyes but your entire face." You heard that right. The shape of your eyebrows can create an appearance of symmetry within your face. And shaping and arching your brows is a whole lot easier than, you know, trying to change the shape of your face. Brown is the most common eye color by a landslide. According to World Atlas, anywhere from 55 to 79% of the world's population is thought to have brown eyes. Brown also happens to be the color of the eyes in the ideal female face composite in Solomon's study, as the Natalie Portman-esque face features dark, almond-shaped eyes. According to L'Oréal Paris, there are 6 general eye shapes a person can have: monolids, round, almond, downturned, upturned, and hooded. Each of the 6 shapes has its own unique characteristics. If you're not sure how to tell if you have almond-shaped eyes, here's a tip. According to the site, if you have a visible crease in your eyelid and your iris touches both the top and bottom of your eyelid, you likely have yourself a pair of almond-shaped peepers. Congratulations! The company further revealed that almond eyes are, quote, super symmetrical. When accentuating almond eyes, a person doesn't have to try to give the illusion of perfect symmetry with eye makeup and can instead use makeup to accent their natural eye shape. However, it's important to note that any pair of healthy peepers is a good pair. When it comes to the ideal nose, Chris Solomon and his team discovered slim and small sniffers to be the most preferred. Plastic surgeons have noted a similar infatuation with itty-bitty noses. When speaking with CBS News, cosmetic surgeons Richard W. Fleming and Toby G. Mayer revealed the noses women have been asking for the most, which included Natalie Portman's, Emma Stone's, and Nicole Kidman's noses. But why are tiny noses so desirable? Radhika Sangani, the woman who started the hashtag side profile selfie movement on social media, gave her opinion in an article for Grazia, writing, "My theory is beauty standards have lauded small noses over big ones because they fit in with the idea of women being delicate, dainty, and not taking up space. But we're not. We're bold, strong, and we can take up as much space as we want, even with our bodies. Big, small, crooked, straight, embrace the nose you've got." Small noses may be idealized, but the same principle apparently does not apply to lips. Chris Salmon's female composite has full lips, and in addition to Natalie Portman, the study cited Scarlett Johansson and Emilia Clarke as having the ideal lips. It's probably no surprise that plastic surgeons Richard W. Fleming and Toby G. Mayer have found this to be the case as well. The doctors told CBS News that Scarlett Johansson has the most requested lips of any celebrity, revealing that women also look to Angelina Jolie and Christina Aguilera for their lip inspo. Michael C. Edwards, president of the American Society for Aesthetic Plastic Surgery, explained why people find fuller lips most attractive on women, saying, "People may think a fuller lip is more sensual, or they may be influenced by pop culture and social media.
I love who I am, and I'm honestly not trying to be Kim Kardashian at all."
One of the most interesting aspects of Chris Salmon's beautiful face study is the vast difference between the ideal female and male faces. Other than both of the faces having brunette hair and near-perfect facial symmetry, they don't share many other features. When comparing the composite with male celebrities, Salmon and his team discovered that British model David Gandy is as close as one man gets to having the perfect face. Of course, the model's nearly 1 million Instagram followers would likely agree. According to The Scotsman, when Dolce of Dolce & Gabbana first saw the British model, he immediately gave him the impression of embodying a universal ideal of masculine beauty between Michelangelo's David and those chiseled Greek and Roman sculptures of the classic era. Gandy is so seemingly perfect, in fact, that he had trouble finding work on account of being, quote, too good-looking. According to Chris Salmon's study, Mr. Perfect doesn't have a heart-shaped face like his female counterpart. Instead, the ideal face shape for males is oval. As far as hairstyles are concerned, oval-faced men like Ryan Gosling have it easy. After consulting with Men's Hairstyles Today, Business Insider revealed, luckily most hairstyles will look good with an oval face shape. However, the publication did issue a warning for those who may have skipped over the keyword most, explaining, "A word of caution, avoid bangs or fringes that could cover your forehead and make your head appear even rounder than it already is." Ideal male eyebrows differ from perfect female eyebrows in pretty much every way. The male composite face in Chris Salmon's study features medium-thick eyebrows that are straight and curved downwards at the end. Unlike the beauty ideal for women, the ideal male brows are neither shaped nor arched. Not all men pay attention to their brows, but Romero Jennings, director of makeup artistry for MAC Cosmetics, is a staunch believer that they should. Jennings revealed to HuffPost, "Brows are really personal. Brows really give you expression. Brows can make you look strong or weak or powerful or not. A brow will give you approachability. If it's too strong or severe, someone will pass you by."
That is a great look for me!
However, dudes should use caution when sculpting their brows. Jennings recommends men meet with a groomer who has experience sculpting men's brows as opposed to visiting any old salon. The male composite face in Chris Salmon's study illustrates that the majority of folks find both oval-shaped eyes and blue eyes to be the most attractive on men. Blue may be the second most common eye color, but it's much more rare than brown. Oval-shaped eyes are even more rare. A combination of round and almond, oval isn't considered one of the six most common eye shapes. If you're a little confused, just take a look at former soccer star David Beckham, actor Bradley Cooper, and model David Gandy. All three of these stars are perfect examples of the eyes deemed most attractive for males. In January 2019, David Beckham proved that women and men alike can use eye makeup to play up their peepers when he graced the cover of Love magazine wearing a shade of bright green eyeshadow. And according to his superstar wife, this wasn't the first time Beckham wore makeup. Victoria Beckham revealed to Elle, "David does steal my beauty products. It doesn't annoy me. He looks so beautiful. We can't argue with that." While it's desirable for men to have slim noses, the facial composite study revealed that they shouldn't be too small. Instead, mid-length and straight were the defining factors of the ideal male schnoz, as well as being proportionately larger than that of the female composite. A study published in the American Journal of Physical Anthropology revealed that, on average, men have larger noses than women, so it's not too surprising that a larger male nose is considered ideal.
"Excuse me, is that your nose or did a bus park on your face?"
The facial composite study cited both David Beckham and David Gandy as the closest human comparisons. Although neither of these famous men's noses made up the top celebrity rhinoplasty requests, similar slim and mid-length noses did. California plastic surgeons Richard W. Fleming and Dr. Toby G. Mayer told CBS News that Jude Law, Josh Duhamel, and Ben Affleck are the male celebrities with the most requested sniffers. Chris Solomon's study revealed that average lips, which are neither full nor thin, complete the so-called perfect male face. This is also echoed in what plastic surgeons Richard W. Fleming and Dr. Toby G. Mayer have seen in their respective practices. While Solomon's study listed David Beckham and Chris Hemsworth as the celebrities who have the perfect lips, the plastic surgeons told CBS News that Ashton Kutcher and Brad Pitt actually have the most requested lips. Science is cool, but it's important not to allow all this talk of symmetry dictate how you feel about your own appearance. However, it will be interesting to see what the so-called ideal face looks like to future generations. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more List videos featuring the hottest beauty tips are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.